to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Today I'm directing NASA to begin a search in all of our elementary and secondary schools and to choose as the first citizen passenger in the history of our space program, one of America's finest, a teacher.
I would like to humanize the space age by giving a perspective from a non-astronaut because I think the students will look at that and say, this is an ordinary person. This ordinary person is contributing to history, and if they can make that connection, then they're going to get excited about history, they're going to get excited about the future, they're going to get excited about space.
The teacher who will be going into space, Krista McAuliffe. Or is that you?
It's not often that a teacher is at a loss for words. I know my students wouldn't think so. I've made 9 wonderful friends over the last 2 weeks. When that shuttle goes, they might be one body. But there's going to be 10 souls that I'm taking with me. Thank you.
That's great.
I did it. If I can get this far, you know, you can do it too. And I really hope you have a wonderful year, and I'm going to miss all of you.
It is cold here. It is Long John weather at the Cape, and there is some concern about the effect of these cold temperatures.
The crew on their way up the elevator to the 195-foot level, where they will go down the walkway to the white room and prepare for their entrance into the orbiter. The crew is going to find somewhat of a chilly welcome when they arrive. The temperature inside the cabin is about 61 degrees. As they prepare to board, each of them will put on an integrated egress harness and a special helmet.
Challenges from launch director. Welcome to our northern launch facility.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, that's the northernmost pad we've got, and you can probably tell from the icicles out there how far north it is.
Flight crew, this is OTC on UHF. How do you read?
CLT loud clear. CLT loud clear. CMS 1 loud clear.
MS 2 loud clear.
MS 3 loud and clear.
CS 2 loud clear.
CS 1 loud clear.
Good morning, Krista. Hope we go today.
Good morning, Krista, too.
The ground launch sequencer has started retracting the orbiter crew access arm. This is the walkway used by the astronauts to climb in the vehicle, and that arm can be put back in place within about 15 to 20 seconds if an emergency should arise.
Roger, welcome.
Orbiter test conductor has given pilot Mike Smith a go to perform the auxiliary power unit pre-start. He will configure switches in the cockpit to put the auxiliary power units in the ready-to-start configuration. Mission Control has transmitted the signal to start the onboard flight recorders. The two recorders will collect measurements of shuttle system performance during flight to be played back after the mission.
Let's go for orbiter APU start.
CLT, OTT, perform APU start.
LOX replenish has been terminated and liquid oxygen drain back has been initiated. Mike Smith now flipping the three switches in the cockpit to start each of the three auxiliary power units. The solid rocket booster and external safe and arm devices have been armed. Main fuel valve heaters on the three shuttle main engines have been turned on in preparation for engine start. The flight crew has been reminded to close their airtight visors and their launch and entry helmets, and a final purge sequence of the main engines is underway. The orbiter aerosurface test has started. The orbiter flight control surfaces are now being moved through a pre-programmed pattern to verify that they are ready for launch. Orbiter ground support equipment power bus has been turned off, and the vehicle is now on internal power. Aerosurface checks are complete, and aerosurfaces in launch configuration. Gimbal checks of the orbiter's main engines now underway.
Okay, let's go for ET LO2 pressurization.
External tank liquid oxygen pressurization has started, and purging of the shuttle main engines is terminated. Retraction has started of the gaseous oxygen vent hood, and the ground launch sequencer will make a final check to make sure the vent arm is fully retracted at T-minus 37 seconds. Liquid oxygen ullage pressure checks are underway, and the liquid oxygen tank approaching flight pressure. The liquid hydrogen replenish has been terminated, and liquid hydrogen pressurization to flight level is underway. The vehicle is now isolated from all ground propellant and fluid loading equipment. The 51L mission ready to go. The liquid hydrogen tank now at flight pressure and all three engines ready to go. Sound suppression water system now armed. The hydrogen burn igniters have been armed. These igniters will be fired at T-minus 10 seconds to burn off any residual hydrogen gas. The solid rocket booster flight instrumentation recorders have gone into the record mode. T-minus 30 seconds, and we've had a go for auto-sequence start. The SRB hydraulic power units have started. T-minus 21 seconds, and the solid rocket booster engine gimbal now underway. T-minus 15 seconds. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1. And liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Roger, Challenger.
Good roll program confirmed. Challenger now heading downrange. Engines beginning throttling down now at 94%.
Pieces of ice tumble off as the coldest space shuttle launch ever gets underway. Challenger seems to shake herself free of the ice and goes. All five rocket engines burning well. The first teacher, Krista McAuliffe, on her way to space with six other astronauts on board.
Engines throttling up. Three engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go and throttle up.
Well, I guess it should probably know by now I was one who wanted to fly. I wanted to ride on that arrow of fire right up into heaven.
Flight controllers here looking very carefully at the situation.
And I wanted to go for every man, every child, every mother of children. I wanted to carry the dreams of all people right up to the stars.
Obviously a major malfunction.
I prayed that I'd find that answer there. Maybe I would find the song, giving a voice to all of the hearts that cannot be heard.
We have no downlink.
For all of the ones who live in fear, and all of those who stand apart, my being there would bring us a little step closer together.
Contingency procedures are in effect.
They were flying for me, they were flying for everyone. They were trying to see the brighter day for each and every one. They gave us their light, they gave us their spirit and all they could be. They were flying for me, they were flying for me. And I wanted to wish on the Milky Way, that's upon a falling star. I wanted to give myself and free myself and join myself with it all.
News. This is Doug Poling. What appears to be a terrible tragedy at the Kennedy Space Center. The Challenger with seven crew members exploded shortly after it was launched about 20 minutes ago. It went out of control and appears to have fallen into the ocean. We have no word on the fate of the crew.
It is the worst disaster in the history of the American space program, and President Reagan has declared a week of mourning for the seven astronauts, five men and two women, who lost their lives on their way into space this morning.
The crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger honored us for the manner in which they lived their lives. We will never forget them, nor the last time we saw them this morning, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye and slipped the surly bonds of Earth to touch the face of God. We remember
Dick Scobee, the commander who spoke the last words we heard from the Space Shuttle Challenger. He served as a fighter pilot in Vietnam, earning many medals for bravery. Later, as a test pilot of advanced aircraft before joining the space program. Danger was a familiar companion to Commander Scobee. We remember Michael Smith, who earned enough medals as a combat pilot to cover his chest, including the Navy Distinguished Flying Cross, three air medals, and the Vietnamese Cross of Gallantry with Silver Star, in gratitude from a nation he fought to keep free. We remember Judith Resnick, known as JR to her friends, always smiling, always eager to make a contribution, finding beauty in the music she played on her piano in her off hours. We remember Ellison Onizuka, who as a child running barefoot through the coffee fields and macadamia groves of Hawaii, dreamed of someday traveling to the moon. Being an Eagle Scout, he said, had helped him soar to the impressive achievements of his career. We remember Ronald McNair, who said that he learned perseverance in the cotton fields of South Carolina. His dream was to live aboard the space station, performing experiments and playing his saxophone in the weightlessness of space. Well, Ron, we will miss your saxophone, and we will build your space station. We remember Gregory Jarvis. On that ill-fated flight, he was carrying with him a flag of his university in Buffalo, New York. A small token, he said, to the people who unlocked his future. We remember Christa McAuliffe, who captured the imagination of the entire nation, inspiring us with her pluck, her restless spirit of discovery, a teacher not just to her students, but to an entire people, instilling us all with the excitement of this journey we ride into the future. We will always remember them, and we will cherish each of their stories. The Challenger crew was pulling us into the future, and we'll continue to follow them. We'll continue our quest in space. There will be more shuttle flights and more shuttle crews. Yes, more volunteers, more civilians, more teachers in space. Nothing ends here. Our hopes and our journeys continue.
It's a real pleasure to be at the Cape, to come down here and participate in something that the Cape does better than anybody in the world, and that's launching space vehicles.
It's good to be down here, to be flying a vehicle that we know a lot of folks down here have worked very hard on. We understand it's ready to go, and we're looking forward to going to fly. Getting on orbit and getting the secret handshake.
I am hoping that the affliction that Steve Hawley had from the 41D mission specialist hasn't rubbed off on me, otherwise they might throw me off the flight.
Looking forward to going to fly this one. I think we got some real interesting payloads.
we're ready to go fly.
I had the privilege of being a part of the crew that made the first landing here at the Cape, and I intend to be a part of the crew to make the first return landing to the Cape.
It's a great pleasure finally to get this far. I am very proud to be part of the program that NASA and Hughes have put together as their payload specialists.
Oh, I am so excited to be here. I don't think any teacher has ever been more ready to have two lessons. I've been preparing these since September, and I just hope everybody tunes in to watch the teacher teaching from space.
The day we promised Dick Scobee and his crew that their dream lives on, that the future they worked so hard to build will become reality. Man will continue his conquest of space to reach out for new goals and ever greater achievements. That is the way we shall commemorate our seven Challenger heroes. Dick, Mike, Judy, Elle, Ron, Greg, and Krista. Your families and your country mourn your passing. We bid you goodbye. We will never forget you. For we know in our hearts that you who flew so high and so proud now make your home beyond the stars, safe in God's promise of eternal life.
Joining me here at our CBS News headquarters at the Kennedy Space Center, Bruce Hall, our veteran space watcher. Bruce, you can feel the anticipation rising here, what that crew must be thinking. Is it a different kind of crew for this launch?
Dan, it certainly is a different kind of crew, because this time, for the first time, we have an all-veteran shuttle crew. The commander is 47-year-old Frederick Hauck. 42-year-old Richard Dick Covey is the pilot, and it was his voice everyone heard giving the final instructions to Challenger crew, go at throttle up. John Mike Lounge, 42-year-old astrophysicist, 38-year-old Marine Lieutenant Colonel Dave Hilmers, George Pinky Nelson, youngest member of the crew.
We've never had one with all shuttle veterans before.
No rookies this time.
The crew's aboard, strapped in and ready to go. This morning, thousands of people lined up all up and down the Florida Space Coast, hoping to see them light up the shuttle and send it up for the first time in 32 months.
1-0. Liftoff. Americans return to space as Discovery clears the tower.
Roger, roll, Discovery.
Crew confirms roll program. Houston now controlling. Three engines at 104%. Velocity 2,300 feet per second. Altitude 5.9 nautical miles. Downrange distance 3 nautical miles.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
Roger. Discovery given a go at throttle up. Three engines at 104%. Velocity 3,200 feet per second. Altitude 10.8 nautical miles. Downrange distance 8 nautical miles. 25 seconds from solid rocket booster separation. 1 minute, 45 seconds. Three engines at 104%. Velocity 4,800 feet per second, altitude 20 nautical miles, downrange distance 19 nautical miles. Standing by for solid rocket booster separation. Solid rocket boosters have separated.
Good evening. The all-veteran five-member crew of Discovery is in orbit, and here at the Kennedy Space Center, they're floating on air. The space shuttle program is off the ground again. 2.5 years after Challenger, this is the shakedown flight of a redesigned shuttle program, mission accomplished.
At 11:37, the space shuttle Discovery lifted off at the Kennedy Space Center and is now headed into orbit, and America is back in space.
As we, the crew of Discovery, witness this earthly splendor from America's spacecraft, less than 200 miles separates us from the remainder of mankind. But lest we ever forget that to ascend through this seemingly tranquil sea will always be fraught with danger, let us remember the Challenger crew whose voyage was so tragically short.
Today, we can say at long last to Dick, Mike, Judy, to Ron and Al, and to Krista and Greg. Dear friends, we have resumed the journey that we promised to continue for you. Your loss has meant that we could confidently begin anew. Your spirit and your dream are still alive in our hearts.